Time balls, Joe Caruso, quarterback for Lock Haven, tosses two touchdowns into the mix, hitting Brian Kramer and Dan Johnson. In the second half, Galitsky, play Galitsky they call him, he pops into the end zone to cap the scoring and give Lock Haven the AAA title in convincing fashion, 29-0. To double up, Teal a touchdown better than St. Francis. It's Juniata upsetting Wilkes, 14-0. Lock Haven, District 6 championship next week. Tonight, single, double, and AAA winners advancing to their respective title games at Mansion Park next Saturday. One such team is Lock Haven. It's the Bobcats blowing out Central Cambria 41-16 at Tyrone. Joe Carnes, the screen pass to Chris Knarr. It goes 10 yards for a 14-0 second quarter Lock Haven lead. In the third, Hayes Galitsky, big play Galitsky, piling up the yardage again tonight. Romps for 35 yards. This would set up a touchdown for Lock Haven. And it'll be Dave Saylor carrying the mail home from there. 15 yards out, the Bobcats advance to the AAA title game next week against Huntington. It'll also be Penns Valley advancing to play in the title game of the AA division, beating Southern Huntington for the second time this year, 28-8 the final. Salzburg ends Claysburg's season in the single.
national champion at Lock Haven State College, and of course, a member of our Sports Hall of Fame. In addition, I've asked Mrs. Clara Eckley, member of our Keystone Central School Board, to join us. Tonight, we will be adding a 13th member to our Wall of Fame, and I'm very pleased to introduce the 13th member, retired principal of Logan Mindy High School, Harold Adams. Would you come forward, Mr. Adams? He never donned a uniform as a competitor at Ben. He never coached a team, at least not officially. But he's always been a dedicated, loyal, and supportive administrator. One of the things that you can always say was he was supportive of our student body, our student activities, particularly the athletic department. I think that any coach that coached under Harold Adams or any athlete who represented his high school while he was principal would say the same thing, that he was a friend of Baldwin Whitney High School. Tonight, as you leave the gym, I would appreciate it if you would look up at the wall at the new picture. Mr. Wall Eisen, would you kind of show everyone what that's going to look like? Lastly, we are presenting to Mr. Adams, Will Reed, in honor of 30 years of devoted service to Baldwin Whitney High School. He was a student's biggest supporter, whether in the area of academics, fine arts, or athletics. Mr. Adams will always be regarded as a loyal and dedicated administrator by his students, faculty, and staff. Amen. One last thing, those of you who have been coming to Baldwin Whitney High School for years, when you came into the gym this year, you saw a little bit different look with the paint and so forth, and that comes from the support of our superintendent, our Board of Education, maintenance department, faculty, even Mr. Wallace was painting, and students. And one last fitting touch. This day, 4th, Baldwin Whitney High School, this facility will come to be known as the Harold Adams Gymnasium at Baldwin Whitney High School. Harold Adams.